Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today is the day of Arafah, one of the most or the holiest day of the year for the Muslims. Alhamdulillah, if you fast today, Allah will forgive 1 year past and 1 year to come for you. Inshallah, today we took the challenge to walk for Arafah or Arafah walk for Africa, and we are starting from the Central Mosque in Birmingham, the Islamic Culture Center of Birmingham, which had a lot of favor on Islamic Relief and all the Muslim organization, not only in Birmingham, but in the country. And we have the chairman today to speak to you.
Jazakallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's a great honor and privilege for us to welcome Dr. Hani to commence his walk, his 11-kilometer walk from here. It's a great deed, a great charitable work he's doing at the moment, and wish him all the best. And I request everyone to make as much donation as they can for this great cause. Thank you very much. Jazakallah.
Thank you, Hashim. And now we have got the oldest challenger working with us. Her name is Erin. Speak. Tell the people what you're going to do.
I'm going to walk.
Loud.
I'm going to walk.
For what?
Africa.
To ask them to raise fund for Africa.
Yes.
Tell them.
I'm going to walk for Africa.
Yes?
What are you raising money for?
Africa.
She's raising fund for Africa, inshallah, and she is challenging every and any one of you at home sitting and watching television or playing computer games or just still sleeping in his bedroom. Erin, how old are you?
9.
She is 9 and she's going to walk for at least 9 kilometers today. not 11 kilometers, maybe 11 kilometers and other. You want to say something? Arwa? Come on, Arwa.
I think it's a very good idea Dr. Hani has done. Although we can't actually be doing Arafah in Mecca and Medina, alhamdulillah, we found an alternative way, and inshallah we'll get the same rewards and we'll get it by helping people in Africa as well. So alhamdulillah, I think it's a good idea. Inshallah, go on to Dr. Hani's page and make a generous donation.
Thank you. Sarah?
Assalamu alaikum everybody. Me and Erin are joining Dr. Hani today to walk for Africa, aren't we?
Mm.
Yes?
Yeah.
And we wish everyone a blessed day on this amazing day that comes once a year. Please make as much donations as you can. The link is on Dr. Hani's page. And please join us if you can, if you're in Birmingham.
Thank you. Yusra? Okay. Hashim? Okay. Now we're going to start. We started from the Central Mosque or Islamic Culture Center, then going to Green Lane Mosque, then going to Dar al-Ulum Mosque in Coventry Road, then going to Gamgol Sharif Mosque on the highway, then from Gamgol Sharif is to Anderton Road Mosque, what do you call it? Sparkbrook Islamic Center. Then from there, we can go to Amana Mosque. Then from Amana Mosque, we're going, inshallah, to go to Muslim Student House Mosque. Then we are going to Khoja Shia, what's the name of the mosque?
Clifton Road
Mosque, Shia Brothers Mosque. And the last mosque will be Station Road Mosque, which is another Brelwi mosque. When we used to raise fund in 1985 and 86, at the very, very, very good old days, which is none of you have seen it. So see you in next stop, which is in Green Lane Mosque. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. See you next stop, see you next stop, see you next stop. السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. هذه هي المحطة الثانية لنا في مسجد جرين لين في برمنغهام. مشينا 3 كيلو الحمد لله. Our second stop after actually walking for 3 kilometers when we started from Islamic Culture Center in Birmingham. And we are hosted by Brother Hamayon, who is actually one of the committee in the mosque.
السلام عليكم. I'm so glad to host Dr. Hani. MashaAllah, he started Islamic Relief from Birmingham, and as one of the masajid of Birmingham, it's always our pleasure to host him. Islamic Relief are our charity partner as well, and alhamdulillah, it's always a pleasure. And whenever we see Dr. Hani doing his walks, it always inspires us. Probably the more walking in this one day than I have for the last few months. So Jazakallah Sheikh and Doctor, you're an inspiration. And inshallah, hope you raise money today. Arafa Walk for Africa. Please donate.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. We're doing an 11-kilometer walk for Africa on behalf of the Islamic Relief, and we'd love for you to join us.
Thank you. Irin, your message.
We have arrived to
Green Lane Mosque.
Green Lane Mosque, and we did
3 kilometers. Walk for Africa.
Walk for Africa.
Thank you. Imran.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Please join us and donate on behalf of Islamic Relief and Walk for Africa.
Inshallah. Arafa, Walk for Africa. Arwa, where's Arwa? Come on. Sahila, you want to stay? This is Sister Sahila as well.
Alhamdulillah, we've got the Green Lane Masjid. We were just saying that it felt much, much quicker. We didn't feel the heat, alhamdulillah. SubhanAllah, it's like 27 degrees and nobody's complaining or feeling hot. I think it's the barakah in the walk, alhamdulillah. So, 9 more kilometers, inshallah, and I think it's going to be very easy.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Alhamdulillah, we've done 3 kilometers and we've enjoyed the walk in the sunshine in Birmingham. We look forward to more volunteers and donations. Jazakallah khair.
Shukran, thank you. الرسالة بتاعتنا ان احنا يوم عرفة مش يوم حننام فيه، يوم حنعمل فيه، يوم حنصلي فيه، يوم حندعو فيه، يوم حنتصدق فيه، يوم حنعمل فيه كل أعمال الخير. والشباب اللي معايا دول كلهم بسم الله ما شاء الله من سن 9 سنين لسن 19 سنة. I am 19 years old. أوكي؟ عرفة، مسيرة عرفة من أجل أفريقيا. مسيرة عرفة من أجل أفريقيا. الحمد لله احنا عملنا أول 3 كيلومتر ونقص لنا 8 كيلومتر إن شاء الله، ونتمنى أنكم تساعدونا وتكونوا معنا إن شاء الله، إما بالمشي أو بالدعاء أو بالتبرع. واللينك موجود عندكم، الرابط موجود عندكم في الصفحة. Anybody else want to speak? Well, thank you. Where's the brother from Green Mosque? He's gone?
Someone's come from the thing, so you have to go.
Okay. We thank the people, the brothers and sisters in Green Mosque, Green Lane Mosque, for hosting us. We have another 7 mosques to go. عندنا 7 مساجد أخرى حنقف عندها. بعد كده دار العلوم في كوفنتري، في شارع كوفنتري، جمجول شريف على الهايواي، وبعدين المركز الإسلامي سبارك بروك، وبعدين الأمانة، وبعدين الدار، وبعدين مركز الشيعة، وبعدين مركز اللي هو ستيشن رود. Come on, Brother Hamayoun, to thank everybody before we leave. Thank you, Green Lane. You have the first million with you?
Sorry?
The first million?
The first million, inshallah. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh, for coming. And inshallah, we hope that you raise your target today once again. You know, Jazakallah khair for coming and visiting us at the masjid.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, hadha huwa al-masjid al-thalith, lo dar al-ulum. اللي احنا كنا بنيجي هنا في الثمانينات عند الدكتور عبد الرحيم رحمة الله عليه نجمع التبرعات ونتكلم عن أفريقيا ونتكلم عن كل دول في العالم. احنا مشينا النهاردة 4 كيلومترات من 11 كيلو وده المسجد التالي اللي احنا فيه ان شاء الله من carry on. We walked already for Africa for 4 kilometers since we started at 12 o'clock and this is our third stop. It is Dar al-Ulum Islamic Center. I remember the good old days when late Dr. عبد الرحيم was actually inviting us to speak, to stay in the mosque, to eat in the mosque, and to fundraise in the mosque. Now I have with me the second and third generation, which are going to say something about Arafa Walk for Africa.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Just to update you, we've done 4 kilometers so far with the remaining 7 kilometers. We've really enjoyed the walk. The weather's been really nice. And we would absolutely love for you guys to join us. It's not too late, so come.
Thank you. Erin?
Assalamu alaikum. We have arrived to our third
stop.
And
walked for 4 kilometers.
We walked for 4 kilometers for Africa. It's not too late. Join us.
Please join us. Thank you. Jazakum Allah khair. We'll see you in Gamgol Sharif, inshallah, in about nearly half an hour time. Be tuned and we'll see you there. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. سنراكم في مسجد جمجول شريف إن شاء الله في خلال نصف ساعة، وانتظرونا هناك للبث المباشر من جمجول شريف. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. احنا تعملنا 5.5 كيلو تقريبا منذ أن بدأنا الساعة 12، وده خامس مسجد بنسميه سبارك بروك إسلاميك سنتر، مركز إسلامي لحي سبارك بروك اللي هو تابع اللي هو الجماعة الإسلامية في باكستان أو في بريطانيا. طبعا كل المباني اللي الناحية التانية دي كلها ملك المسجد، واحنا كنا بنيجي هنا زمان في الثمانينات والتسعينات نجمع تبرعات، والمسجد ده ما كانش موجود اصلا ما كانش موجود خالص، لكن موجود مسجد صغير في الشارع اسمه شارع أندرتون رود موسك. احنا حتى المسجد كان اسمه مسجد أندرتون رود. والنهاردة بتتذكر العلاقة اللي بيننا وبين المركز الإسلامي هذا اللي استمرت لأكثر من 30 سنة، زي ما استمرت مع المركز الصوفي اللي احنا شفناه قبل كده، زي ما استمرت مع أهل الحديث اللي هم جرين لين قبل كده هو، وهكذا احنا نتعامل مع جميع الناس الحمد لله. This is our first stop with the mosque in Spark Brook Islamic Center, and our relationship goes back to the 80s and 90s when we used to come here not to this mosque but actually to the old mosque in a road called Anderton Road, and all these buildings around here owned by the mosque, alhamdulillah. And we used to come here to deliver speeches, lectures, and fundraise from the people here in the area. Then they built this beautiful mosque, which is called the Spark Brook Islamic Center, and very well attended by people, alhamdulillah, mainstream people. And now I have one of my colleagues who has been working with me for the last nearly 3 hours, which is Irene, who is not sure, she's 9, and she delivered a message for you. Today we are walking for Africa. Arafah, walk for Africa. Arafah, walk for Africa. Arafah, walk for Africa. Irene.
Assalamu alaikum. We have done 6 kilometers so far, and we are walking for the people in Africa so they can have fresh, clean water. Please donate us. See you at the next stop.
Inshallah. So this is هذا هو المسجد الخامس اللي احنا بنيجي فيه، وان شاء الله نراكم في مسجد الأمانة بعد حوالي 20 دقيقة ان شاء الله. ومن هو السير من اجل افريقيا، سير يوم عرفة من اجل افريقيا. والرسالة هنا للشباب: Please on the day of Arafah don't sit at home, do nothing. Do some charitable activity, visit your family, visit your father, visit your mother, pray, make dua, pay charity, and fast of the day of Arafah, because if you fast the day of Arafah, Allah will wipe the sins of you for 1 year past and 1 year to come. But don't sit at home doing nothing, becoming an armchair warrior, making a hot air discussion and rhetoric discussion. في يوم عرفة احنا بنمشي المشي ده 11 كيلو من اجل الحصول على دعم لبناء مشاريع المياه في افريقيا. في يوم عرفة احنا بنشجع الشباب، نتحدى الشباب، بنقول لهم لابد علينا الا نتقاعس ونحس تعبانين واحنا صايمين. الصوم يوم عرفة يغفر سنة لما فاتت وسنة لتحل فيما بعد. وكذلك اعمل اعمال الخير، اعملي اعمال الخير، زوري اهلك، زوري قرايبك، زوري اصدقائك، ادخلي السرور على ناس غلابه وفقراء الى اخره، لكن لا تجلسوا لا تفعلوا شيء. يعني لذلك انا بشجعكم انكم تتبرعوا من خلال الرابط اللي عندكم من اجل مشاريع المياه في افريقيا. وجزاكم الله خير، وان شاء الله حنراكم في المحطه السادسه. لسه قدامنا 4 محطات، فإن شاء الله نلتقي بكم فيها قبل أن ننتهي من مشي 11 كيلومتر اللي احنا اتفقنا عليها معاكم منذ أيام. وإن شاء الله احنا تقريبا دلوقتي 5.5 كيلو ولسنا كمان 5.5 كيلو إن شاء الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Stay tuned and we'll see you next stop. السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. وصلنا للمركز السادس من مراكز احنا بنزورها النهاردة في يوم عرفة، اللي هو المشي من أجل أفريقيا في يوم عرفة. ومشينا حوالي 6.5 كيلو الحمد لله، واخذت منا حوالي 3 ساعات الى ان نصل هنا. هو المشي من اجل عرفه هو تحدي لكل الشباب اللي قاعدين في البيت ما بيعملوش حاجه، لابد ان احنا نخرج ونعمل اي شيء علشان نساعد الناس في كل مكان وفي كل زمان. We have arrived our sixth stop here to Amana, Ma'ad Welfare Trust, after walking for nearly 3 hours to visit other 5 mosques before that, or Islamic centers, of on Arafah Walk for Africa. And this message is for the young people who are sitting at home doing nothing. You have to meet the challenge, to create the challenge, and to overcome the challenge. With me is Mawlana Imran, and Umm al-Mu'mineen Aisha as well, who are going to tell you about their experience over the last 3 hours. Aisha.
I'm not going to lie, it has been very difficult to stand by in the hot weather, but it's been an experience, and I'm glad I came along. And yeah, I really appreciate you guys organizing this, so a huge thank you.
Encourage them.
It'd be great to see you guys come out here and join us, so please do so.
Assalamu alaikum everybody. It's a lovely day outside here in Birmingham. And all that we ask from you guys is to support us in our long walk. Inshallah, hopefully, I think it's going to be about a 5-hour walk today. So inshallah, please donate to make it worth it. Inshallah, see you at the next stop.
Arim?
We have run so far and seen loads of masjid. Please come to the next stop. I hope you come to the next stop. See you later.
Inshallah, Irene asking you to come and meet the challenge. She has been walking with us for the last 3 hours, 6.5 kilometers. And this is a message for the people sitting at home doing nothing. If Irene can do it, you can do it. إيرين بتتكلم معنا النهاردة في المشي من أجل عرفة، من أجل المية في أفريقيا، علشان بتقول لنا إنها مشيت 6.5 كيلو الحمد لله، ووصلت لهنا في 3 ساعات اللي فاتت دول. بتقول لكم كلكم تعملوا زي ما هي عملت. شكرا إيرين، شكرا إيرين، شكرا إيرين. You look like me. إن شاء الله هنشوفكم في المحطة الجاية اللي هو 517 موزلي رود مسلم ستينز هاوس، اللي احنا المكان اللي احنا بدأنا فيه العمل مع الأغاثة الإسلامية من 37 سنة. We'll see you in the next stop inshallah in about 40 minutes time in 517 Mosley Road, Muslim Student House, where we started Islamic Leaf in 1984. See you there guys, stay tuned. نراكم هناك inshallah. انتظرونا بشغف. مش عارفين شغف يعني ايه؟ والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أيها الأخوة والأخوات الكرام، نحييكم من المحطة 7 للمسجد 7 اللي هو مسجد دار الطلبة المسلمين 517 موزلي رود، واللي بدأت فيه الإغاثة من عام 1984، يعني قرابة 37 سنة. فعم نتكلم عن تاريخ كبير جدا جدا. هنا بدأنا العمل، عمل اجتماعي، عمل إنساني، عمل للجمعيات، عمل للشباب، إلى آخره إلى آخره. من هنا أشياء أخرى. اليوم صارت في الموجينج. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته أيها الإخوة والأخوات. ده المسجد 7 أو المركز الإسلامي 7 اللي احنا وصلنا له في رحلتنا اليوم، المشي يوم عرفة من أجل أفريقيا. احنا مشينا حاليا 8.5 كيلو لقرابة 4 ساعات مع الشباب اللي انتم شايفينهم زي الورد دول. وهنا بدأنا منذ 37 سنة عمل الإغاثة الإسلامية في داخل هذا المكان المبارك اللي أخرج الإغاثة الإسلامية أعمال أخرى، أعمال اجتماعية وشبابية ومجتمعية كثيرة في خلال 40 سنة الماضية. واليوم بنحقق هذا الرقم، نكمل 11 كيلو زي ما احنا عملنا في رمضان وعملنا للبوسنة كذلك. وإن شاء الله تكونوا معنا في هذا المشي من أجل أفريقيا. Today إن شاء الله we have reached the 7th stop of our challenge walk, Arafah walk for Africa, and we are reaching 517 Mosley Road, which is very dear Islamic center for all of us. This is where we started Islamic Leaf 37 years ago with 20 pence, with young people, young men and young women who managed to build this big organization, alhamdulillah. And today we are working for Africa. We walked for 8.5 kilometers. We still have got 2 Islamic centers to go and to finish in Station Road after going to the Shia Mosque, which is next, inshallah. I have Irene with me to urge you to stand with us in our challenge.
Assalamu alaikum. We have arrived to our 7th stop. And we have been doing this for the people in Africa so they can have clean, fresh water. I hope you'll join. Please donate for us. It's not too late.
Thank you. ومعنا أروى كذلك.
Assalamu alaikum. It feels like a very fitting place. One of the masjids to stop at is the Muslim Student House where Islamic Relief started 36 years ago. Alhamdulillah, it's going well. We keep picking up people on our way and people are joining in and they're donating. So please go on to Dr. Hani's page and donate. It is getting a little bit more difficult, but inshallah, we're almost finished.
أرجع مرة ثانية أقول التحدي اليوم مش عشان نجمع تبرعات. التحدي اليوم للشباب اللي قاعدين في البيت ما بيعملوش حاجة. قاعدين محبطين، قاعدين بيقرقدوا في صوابعهم، قاعدين بيتفرجوا على التلفزيون، قاعدين بيتفرجوا على ميسي ورونالدو كريستيانو رونالدو محمد صلاح ومكة وبنته مش عارف تاني اسمها مدينة ولا اسمها القدس إلى آخره. كل الحاجات دي بطيخ بطيخ بطيخ. فذلك today I'm talking about my message today is for the young people who are sitting at home doing nothing, watching television, playing on PlayStation, playing on social media, watching football, arguing about Muhammad Salah or Messi or Cristiano Ronaldo or Mecca, the daughter of Muhammad Salah, or the second daughter of Muhammad Salah, or third daughter of Muhammad Salah. So what does that to do with you? Stand up, make a challenge, meet the challenge, overcome the challenge. Today, the challenge or making a challenge and will overcome the challenge Allah inshallah for Africa. اليوم يوم عرفة ان شاء الله وكلنا صايمين باذن الله سبحانه وتعالى علشان ربنا يغفر لنا سنه فاتت وسنه جايه. احنا واقفين من اجل المياه في افريقيا، من اجل الشباب، من اجل جمع الاموال في افريقيا. فلذلك ايها الشباب وايها الشابات التلفزيونيات والفيسبوكيات والتويتريات والانستغراميات والواتسابيات اذا ترايت اعملوا تحدي وقفوا التحدي وعدوا التحدي وعايزينكم تقفوا من اجل افريقيا. Today again I'm repeating it. Stand up. Fast on the day of Arafah. When you fast on the day of Arafah, Allah will forgive 1 year past for you the sins and another year to come, inshallah. And while you are fasting, do a lot of charitable activity, social activity for everybody, anybody. Meet the challenge. Don't be sitting doing nothing, biting your nails and talking about as becoming an armchair warrior. No. We don't want young people to be like that. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Next stop will be at the Shia Mosque, inshallah, in about 15 minutes or 20 minutes. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. بعد 15 20 دقيقة هنكون في مسجد الشيعة إن شاء الله. نراكم هناك. انتظرونا بشغف بشغف بشغف. Stay tuned. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We've reached the number 8 mosque. الحمد لله. We just finished Muslim Student House a few minutes ago. And now we are in Shia Mosque, Khoja Mosque, Clifton Road Mosque. And you can, alhamdulillah, done by the community here in Clifton Road. And to have Maulana, the Imam of the Mosque, Brother Noor, inshallah, can talk to you about the project, inshallah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. First of all, is to thank Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for gracing us with this wonderful opportunity on this auspicious day of Arafah to welcome our father, our Murabbi, Dr. Albanna, who is on this very, very important Arafah walk to raise funds for water in Africa. I think it's something that all of us need to welcome and cherish and honor. That is what exactly what our beloved prophet stood for. We are standing here at our mosque, Clifton Road Mosque, as you heard it from Doc. This mosque has a lot of members, more than 2,000 people come and pray at this mosque. And alhamdulillah, through the barakat of Allah and the help of the members of the community, you can see the mosque is also under construction to expand the mosque because of the number of people who come to pray here. So we welcome you, and inshallah we support this project and this work 100%. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to inspire Doctor to continue to inspire us, inshallah, to follow and emulate his footsteps, inshallah.
Sister,
you want to say something? This is our brother Mahdi, come.
You want to say something?
Yeah.
Assalamu alaikum. This is our 8th stop. We have explored a lot of the city and seen lots of masjids. Join us for our last stop. Please donate us to help the people in Africa have fresh water.
Thank you. Sister Arwa?
Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah, it was a much, I think this is the quickest stop from the last masjid, so it's getting easier and we just have one more stop. So make sure you go onto Dr. Hani's page and please donate generously. It's the most beloved day of the whole year, so please be generous, inshallah.
Inshallah. Brother?
Assalamu alaikum. We welcome you all at Clifton Road Mosque. Mashallah, it's an amazing project that you're doing, walking across Birmingham at the different mosques, and I encourage everyone to support the project and donate generously. Asant.
I'll say it in Arabic.
Yes. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah. هذا هو المسجد الثامن في رحلتنا رحلة 11 كيلو من أجل جمع المال وجمع العقول والقلوب من أجل أفريقيا. إن شاء الله احنا خلصنا تقريبا 8 كيلو ونص ناقصنا حوالي 2 كيلو ونص لغايه ما نوصل لاخر مسجد الحمد لله. ومعانا مولانا هنا في مسجد اخواننا اللي هم الشيعة هنا هو وده لما اشوف المكان بسم الله ما شاء الله الاستثمار في اوقاف لاموال المسلمين في انا فاكر المسجد I remember the mosque 25 years ago.
Oh, ما شاء الله.
1991.
Oh, ما شاء الله.
1991 لما كنا بنجمع مال عشان زلزال ايران. We're raising fund for Iran earthquake. No. BAM is 2003. Iran earthquake, which is 1991. Okay, because you were not born at that time.
Maybe by then I was ready.
لما كنا بنجمع مال هنا مع الخوجة اللي موجود معانا هنا هو في المسجد كنا احنا اول مؤسسة تجمع المال للضحايا الزلزال ايران في عام 1991. احنا بنقول للشباب رسالتنا واضحة جدا 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 في يوم عرفة احنا بنمشي من اجل افريقيا طبعا بنمشي من اجل سبحانه وتعالى ومن اجل افريقيا عشان نجمع المال ليها من اجل انشاء مشاريع مياه صالحة للشرب لاهلنا في افريقيا في كل مكان في افريقيا ان شاء الله. نشكركم ونلتقي بكم ان شاء الله بعد على الاقل ساعة او اكتر عشان ده اخر محطة من المحطة اللي هو المحطة التاسعة بالنسبة لنا. We'll meet with you over an hour inshallah when we go to the last mosque to be there, which was another mosque used to raise fund in 84, 85, 86. That 84, 85, 86. Do you want to conclude with dua or something?
Inshallah. No, brothers and sisters, donate generously towards these very important projects. You know, water is a source of life, and the Holy Quran makes it crystal clear. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. Each and everything is given life through water. You know, that is one thing one cannot live without. And you know, it is very inspiring to see Dr. Hani walking in this beautiful city of Birmingham on this auspicious day of Arafah to raise fund for water. Kindly donate generously, and your reward is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Donation on a day like this is double. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to inspire all of us to follow the footsteps of great personalities and leaders like Dr. Hani, to also try as much as we can to reach out to those who are in need. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward Dr. and his family and those who work with him abundantly in this dunya and hereafter.
All of us,
inshallah. And those who donated so far, may Allah reward you and multiply your wealth abundantly. And those who have not yet donated, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften our hearts to donate generously towards this great project. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Shukran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. وصلنا إلى نهاية المسيرة وعملنا 11 كيلو 600 متر وده المسجد التاسع اللي أنا كنت بتكلم عنه في الصباح من قبل اللي هو كنا بنيجي هنا في سنة 85 و86 نجمع منه التبرعات وكان مسجد صغير جدا كنا لما نجمع منه 100 جنيه أو 200 جنيه نبقى فرحانين جدا الحمد لله فبفضل الله سبحانه وتعالى المشي النهاردة عشان أفريقيا كان موفق بالرغم من ما شايفين كده في اللي هم النمل الطائر بيحوط بينا يعني the flying ants are actually surrounding us النمل الطائر مش عارف ايه اللي حصل هنا في المنطقة دي يمكن في بركة بالنسبة لنا احنا عسل مثلا ولا احنا شهد ولا احنا بطيخ الى اخره والتحدي النهاردة بالنسبة للشباب زي ما قلت انا قبل كده هو انك تخرج من بيتك تعمل شيء في يوم عرفة من اجل الاخرين وتقعد في البيت وتفعل لا شيء. Today الحمد لله we have reached the final destination of our 11 kilometer walk. It becomes 11.6 kilometer and this is the mosque number 9 that actually we have reached and in this mosque we used to come here in the 80s to raise fund from Station Road Mosque. And if we raised 100 or 200 pounds at that time, it will become just a big target for us to reach. My message today for the people on the day of Arafah, please, young men and women, don't sit at home doing nothing. Start creating challenges. Start meeting challenges. Start overcoming any challenge. And with me now is Zia Salik and brother Omar and sister Arwa will give you a statement.
Inshallah. Go on, man.
Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah, it's been an amazing experience walking across the city of Birmingham, going to numerous masjids from numerous communities. And it gives us an insight into how difficult it is for people to get water, to survive, you know, a basic necessity of life. And it's been an enlightening experience and one which makes us realize how grateful we should be for the fact that we do have easy access to water. And inshallah, do continue to support this cause and make a difference in this world and continue to donate to this cause and allow the poor people of this world to have access to water, inshallah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, as-salatu as-salamu ala rasulil kareem. Alhamdulillah, all of these experiences, they're always great reminders for us. You can see none of us are carrying anything. We don't have any bags or anything heavy. And still after 5, 6, 7, 8 kilometers, you start to feel the weight of just the walk itself with nothing. And subhanAllah, we've walked just short of 12 kilometers and we're tired, all of us. But the whole point of this journey was to raise awareness of course, the projects that we're raising funds for today, which is Water for Life in Africa, which is something that is Sadaqa Jariya for those that donated, but more importantly, for our sisters in places like East Africa, where they walk on average the distance we've walked today, 7 to 8 kilometers each way to get water. And when they go to that source of water, it's often contaminated. So they're bringing home dirty water, which is, you know, in jerry cans of 5 to 10 kilos. So they're carrying 5 to 10 kilos on their shoulders, on their heads, on their backs. And, you know, they're taking that home and they're drinking that water which is contaminated. The efforts of these guys, and mashallah, we had lots of people joining us along the journey, and many of them saw us and took part. Some of them had to leave early. But the efforts of that means that inshallah, our young sisters will be able to stay home, they'll be able to go to school. Our women in these communities, they can stay safe in their close vicinity and have clean drinking water. Today we're fasting and, you know, the sun is beating down. It's nowhere near the heat of Africa, but it's warm. And it, as Omar just said, it really makes you appreciate the importance of the liquid of life, which is water, and how much we take it for granted. We just turn the tap on and we have access to clean water. So I hope that inshallah the efforts of everybody taking part, and ultimately the aim of this project, as Dr. Hani said several times throughout the day, is not just the raising of funds, but really just to get people to think and to feel that they have to do something, take some action. Not just hear what's being said, but get up, do something, take part in a challenge, do some kind of activity of your own. And especially on this day, we ask that inshallah you all make dua for us, and we'll make dua for everybody that's watching. May Allah bless all of you. May Allah reward you for your good efforts and your fasting and your sadaqah today. And may Allah make it a means for success in the akhirah, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum.
Sister Arwa.
Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah, we finally reached our last destination. And I think you can tell in the difference from the first video we did in this video, the energy levels, like we're very exhausted. And I think throughout the whole thing, we thought we were going to be fine. And then people just got thirsty. And in the back of your head, you never really think of water being a luxury. But today, it's really just reminded us all how important water is and how important your donations are. I know some people are a little bit worried sometimes to give a pound or 10 pounds and they feel like it's not going to make a difference, but it always does make a difference. So I want to say thank you to everybody that joined us, and may Allah reward you, and may Allah reward everybody that's donated to the page, and inshallah you continue to donate.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نرجع مرة أخرى نقول إن إحنا بدأنا هذا العمل من 37 سنة ب 20 قرش. وتحول هذا العمل إلى ما نراه اليوم بفضل الله سبحانه وتعالى في أكثر من 40 دولة. We started this movement or this action or this humanitarian response more than 37 years ago with 20 pence from a young boy at the age of 9. So now the organization is working in more than 40 countries in the world. Bless you all. Bless you all on this blessed day of Arafah, and may Allah reward you abundantly, you and your family. ربنا يبارك فيكم جميعا النهاردة في اليوم المبارك ده يوم عرفة إن شاء الله, ويجعله يوم مغفرة ورحمة وعتق من النار لكم جميعا. ولا تنسوا أفريقيا, ولا تنسوا أفريقيا. Don't forget Africa. Don't forget Africa. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.